What is going on, everybody? Fluxo here, and welcome to this week's video, where we're going to be diving straight back into Typhon Industries. In this week's episode, we're going to be building our battery facility for all of our drones. Although we have the train collecting most of the ore we need, drones will be able to obtain those last few raw materials that the trains can't reach. Lastly, I just want to thank you all for all your support that you give on a weekly basis. It really does mean the world to me. Like and subscribe for content like this on a weekly basis. That all being said, let's get into this week's build. After consideration, I decided to use a platform above the entrance, so I removed the gridding from the roof to give me a blank canvas to work from. Once everything was removed, I built the platform straight into the rock face to give it structure and bring everything into the terrain. I then started everything off by placing refineries first. I do this to gauge the height of the refinery before I start building the outline. Knowing that I had no room underneath the platform, I encased the refinery in foundations to give myself an idea of the space that I would have for the underfloor logistics. From there, I built the platform for my blender as I knew that I would be feeding the pipework from underneath. I then hollowed out the foundation to allow the pipework to be fed. I then wired up the machines to avoid having to do it at a later date when it becomes more difficult. When everything was wired up, I then started my underfloor pipe network for the machines. Keeping your pipework underground like this is a great way to avoid confusion, as when you use logistics first, you can create a clear view of your logistic networks. As you can see, I'm still only placing foundations where I need them to avoid making any mistakes with the pipework. Lastly, I installed my feeding area for my water to be fed up from the creek down below. Before feeding the pipework from down below, I finished off connecting the network to the outsourcing line for the recycled water from the machines. Lastly, I aligned the feeding pipes and created support platforms for the water pipes themselves. Next, I installed the machinery to make my aluminum casing for the batteries. Once the machines were installed, I finished up by wiring them up to the existing power line. After installing the last input and output lines for the blender, the machines were complete and it was time to move on for the drone parts. As I only needed a small amount of sulfur, bauxite and coal for the input of this build, I decided to bring those resources in via drone. Bringing them in via drone then prevented me from taking any resources from the terrain. Once I was happy with the placement of the drones, I extended the lower support to support the drone platform itself. I then added some slanted concrete beams to give the support itself even more structure. Once I was happy with the placement of everything, I took the roof platform into the rock and then shaped the rest of it around the chimneys. From there, I shaped the platform around the drones and angled the corners to give the shape more character. I added a sign into the support and then finished off the outline of the roof before I encased the drone platforms. With the platforms now encased, I turned the foundation to asphalt and gave the drone station some edging. After that, I finished the outline of the roof and merged the pathway with angled foundations. From there, I added wall edgings and then gave the lower foundation a darker trim. Before encasing the whole build, I added some last logistics for the drones. Lastly, I used road barriers to place foundations central to the drone ports to be numbered. Now having the drone ports encased, I connected the incoming lines to the network. Next up, I created a feed-in floor for the batteries to supply the drones above. With the logistics of the build nearly complete, I moved on to finishing this half of the roof. With not needing to add anything else to the network of logistics, I squared off the floor with foundations and blank canvassed it with concrete. I then ran the last connecting lines to the locations needed to supply the batteries to the drone ports. With everything now in place, I edged off the platform with some wall edging. To finish off the roof, I gave it a boxed outline and then added a gridded look to the center part itself. Before it was time to finish off the inside with detailing, I wanted to add additional foundation edging to give the outside a little bit more structure. Next up, I encased all my ladder beltwork in small concrete pillars. Not only does this look aesthetically pleasing, but it also helps give the build a lot more held together feeling. I then started to paint the inside and outside with asphalt before finishing off the end wall with concrete pillars and signs. After finishing some last minute detailing on the outside, I then moved inside to encase the refineries themselves and foundations before painting and detailing them. Next, I moved on to edging the machines and pathways before implementing patterns around the machines and filling the remaining blank areas in with coated concrete. Before finishing off the balcony, I completed the interior by adding a ramp and some lights throughout. Last but not least, I finished off the balcony by adding a pillared wall and some structured glass with a doorway leading out. Then all that was left to do was to add the backlighting for the drones and then the drones themselves. So there you have it guys, our battery facility is now complete. I hope you guys enjoyed watching this as much as I did building it. I will leave you guys with some shots of the build and operation, but before I do that I just want to thank you all for your support. It really has been overwhelming. Like and subscribe for content like this on a weekly basis. As for myself, I'll catch you all in the Discord.